Hi, AT from CNC at home. Recently, when I was over at Making It Happen, we did a tissue box. And the pattern on the tissue box, for some reason, reminded me of a Celtic knot. Not sure why, it doesn't look like a Celtic knot, but it's just the circular repeating pattern thing, I don't know. Anyway, that got me curious. What would it take to draw a Celtic knot in LightBurn? So, did some looking online, found many people who hand draw these things, which is fantastic, not something that I'd be able to do without a bunch of practice. I did come across just kind of a brief geometry thing. Here's the shape of a Celtic knot or how it's constructed. So with that in mind, I went into LightBurn, tried to duplicate that, and it turned out real nicely. I ended up making three copies of it right on top of each other so that I could do some trimming of the different shapes. That way I can have one for doing the complete outside edge, one for doing the internal cutouts, and then the last one is just the etching of a few lines to make it look like the Celtic knot. So, without any further ado, let's hop into LightBurn and see what it takes to make a basic Celtic knot.
Let me start by apologizing for the lack of a cursor. It didn't get recorded for some reason, even though I told it to. So, let's start with a circle. I'm going to hold the Shift key while I stretch that out so it makes it an actual circle instead of an oval. We'll change it to 100 millimeters in size. And then we will right-click on this and duplicate it so that we'll have two circles, and then I will resize one of those so that it's slightly larger. That was actually a mistake. It needs to be slightly smaller, but I'll correct that later. Now type in 120, and I really should have typed in 80. Not a problem, though. Now, the reason that I duplicated this versus using this option to make a concentric circle, we'll just take a look at that. I'll just put a circle on here. I'll then just tell it that I want another one. We'll make it go to the outside. Okay. Now, let's just highlight this and look at my points and zoom in so you can see what's happening. The inner circle is done as an arc, and the outer circle is done as line segments. And that's just not what we want. I want the whole thing to be vectors, so that's why I ended up doing a duplicate on the circle. Now let's take that inner circle, or the outer circle, whichever one it was. There we go. And we'll duplicate this one as well. So right-click and select Duplicate. And then I'm going to move this by taking its Y position and adding 50, which is half my diameter. Now I will select that initial circle again, holding the Shift key. And then I'm going to choose the Rotate duplication, and I'll make three copies, and it will rotate then around that original circle, center. Now we'll duplicate each one of these, and we'll make a copy of it. I'll just make this 120 millimeters. Select the next one, duplicate, 120, select, duplicate, make it 120. So we're starting to see the Celtic knot. But this is where I realized I made a mistake. There we go. So I'm going to take this circle and I'm going to duplicate it, and then I'll set its diameter to 80 instead of 100. That's the direction we needed to go. Now you can really start to see that Celtic knot shape up. So the next thing I'm going to do is clean this up. And I'll be using the trim function. So to do this, the first thing that we need to do is do a conversion on this. So we'll select it all, and then select Convert to Path. So we've done that. Now we can have it show all of my points. There we go. And then by hovering over the part of the arc that I don't want, I can press the T, and that will trim it to the other arcs. Now the problem is, it doesn't always work the way that you expect it to. And so let me get the most of these here. I can get these by using the trim function. And then I'll come back And I'll show you how to do this last one. So I'll zoom in, and what I will do is I'll hover over the intersection and then press the I to insert a note. And then I can hover over the part I want to get rid of and press the D to delete it. So I added a intersection and then hovered over and delete. Gotta be careful what you're deleting here. Just hover over the parts you want and click delete. Now I'm just going to select this whole thing, and pressing the period key twice, it'll rotate this 180 degrees. There we highlight, rotate it. And now the rest of this is just doing a bunch of trim work. So I'm going to go in and using the T key for trim, the D for delete, and the I for intersection, I'll get everything all trimmed up so that it looks correct. And as I do this, I basically walk myself around the part, going over, under, making sure that this knot is weaving above or underneath the other parts of the shape. And there we go. We have a nice Celtic knot drawn in LightBurn. Now, to cut this out so that the inner parts get removed and the whole thing comes out, we also have to do some etching. I'm going to copy this or duplicate this whole shape and make three shapes. One for the exterior, one for the interior, and one for the etching. So here's one I made into a blue layer, duplicate it again, and make that one a red layer. Now that red layer is going to be my outside edge. So to do that, what we'll do is we'll turn off the blue and the black layers, and then I'll be able to go through and just do some trimming and deleting of the shape so that we get just the exterior. This is one of the easiest ones because you know exactly what you're doing. You're just getting the outside edge. So I'm able to go through here, do some trimming, works really slick. And then once I'm done, I can just go and delete all the interior pieces. So the outside edge is done. Next, I'm going to work on the internal cutouts. And there are basically 6 of those. So I'm going to do that on the blue layer. So I can turn the red layer off because we don't need to see that. And then I will go through and do some trimming on that internal edges as well for the blue layer. This is a little bit trickier than the external edge. You have to pay a little more attention, but it's not too hard. The etching of some of these, the black layer essentially, that is the trickiest of all. So we'll get to that here in just a minute. If you need to, just make sure to use that IA function to hover over an intersection and make sure that you actually get a dot there so that you can trim and delete to that. Zooming in and out really does help as well to make sure that you're getting exactly what it is you want to trim or delete. I'll just clean that up, and there are the pieces that get cut out of the inside. Turn that exterior back on, and it's starting to look really good. All we need is this black layer to do a little bit of etching, and this is going to be the tricky part. So let's turn this black layer on. And I will occasionally turn the blue and the red layers on to make sure I'm doing what I need. But essentially the very center part, there's basically pieces there that I need to keep. And then at each one of the other nodes, there are pieces that I need to keep. So as I'm doing this, you'll see that I turn on and off the blue and the red layers. So I can see what it's looking like. You can kind of see why this is the hardest part to do. Without those other layers on, it doesn't look like much. But that's what you need, just those four lines, and you need that on all three points. And then in the center, there's kind of a three-pointed pinwheel and three other lines that we need to keep. Okay, that looks good. One more time, get this trimmed up and deleted. that deleted off, get this area deleted out, and get that deleted off. There. And we just clean up the center part. Oops, there we go. Okay, and then we're done. We have our three layers. We have our red that's going to cut the whole thing out, the blue that's the internal cutouts, and the black that's our etching. So when this burns, we'll actually start with the etching and then the internal cutouts and finally the external cutouts. Now, we're not going to burn this during this video, but that's the general idea. So here in preview, we can see that. We'll rewind this all the way to the beginning, and then we'll step through it. So here's the etching, those pieces, and then we'll start to burn the cutouts on the internal cutouts. There'll be six of those. And then once those internal cutouts are done, then it goes through and does the external edge. If we were going to actually burn this, I might want to go through and add a couple tabs to hold that in place. Maybe not. But that looks really good. So that's how to make a Celtic knot using light burn. Not so straightforward for some of the trimming, but it's kind of cool once you get it in there and once you get it done. If you like this type of content, think about clicking the like for this video. Also, subscribe to the channel. You'll get more of this kind of content. Anyway, have fun with your CNC at home projects and enjoy making your own Celtic knot.
Oops.